I've now made it to the center of campus, but with all these buildings, it's easy to get lost and disorientated. I'm gonna climb up this structure and get my bearings, but that is easier said than done.
Well, we got a few more inches till I reach the top. My arms are just burning, but at least I made it. And I'm about 307 feet up right now, and I can see all of Berkeley. And behind me are 61 bells of the campanile, which are set to go off every hour. Woo! And this is just phenomenal. And you can see almost entire city of Berkeley. And if you look just across the bay, you can make out the faint outline of San Francisco. But most importantly, I can now see where my next destination is. The library.
The Berkeley library system is the second largest in the nation. Last semester, a student went missing for 2 weeks. When his roommate finally reported his disappearance to the university police, they found him, 20 hours later, studying in the main stacks. He was suffering from severe dehydration and paranoia. He had to be airlifted out by helicopter. I need to make sure this does not happen to me.
Now, I finally made it to my destination. And it's such a relief. But I'm gonna take about 5 minutes to take a break. Oh. It's hard to imagine that there's so many books here, filled with so much information, and sometimes it just makes you feel a little inadequate. But I got a lot of studying ahead of me tonight, and I think it's time to go. I'm in the bowels of the main stacks right now, in the bottommost level, and I'm gonna slowly make my way down this corridor. Any open spots where I can study. You want to be really, really careful. You don't want to be around these corners. You've got antique books that can fall over your head if you're not careful. Getting out of sound. Get down. There's a group of students over there studying for their exams. This is absolutely amazing to see. They're only about 5 meters away. You must never underestimate the brothers. I knew of two brothers who came here and wandered upon a group of studying students. And they were trampled and they were gored. They had to be airlifted out. And they were lucky, lucky, lucky to live. Now you can see they've gone into defensive positions. This is the first warning to me that they're about to charge. I'm getting too close. They're unsure of me. And they're weighing whether or not to take me on or to get another spot. Right now, I'm right at the edge of their comfort zone. But even if I had told them, they might charge. She's starting to edge toward me now. Okay, I've got to find a way around.
If you ever have to face a nerd charge, there's something you can do to save yourself. If she did charge then, I've got to hold my nerve and not try to outrun her. You've got to stand firm, face her, hold that nerve, and then, at the last minute, dive to the side and then find cover. Often due to their poor eyesight, they might just charge right past you.
Okay, and this is where I want to find my book.
You look over here. This is one of them new modern contraptions just to help you save space in the library. And my book is in there. There's an interesting story behind these signs. They say a sophomore, Jonathan Price, was found in here, actually, when somebody closed these on him. And so he was actually trapped in here for 20 hours. And in that time, he somehow managed to finish reading the entire collection of 19th century English literature. Ah, found my book. And this place is just perfect because I've got two solid walls on each side and I have another one here that will prevent me from hearing any distracting sounds and block me from wandering eyes. So, and conveniently, I see another student has left me all their material. So this is a great find for me. Now, it's time to study.
Hey, Bear, time to get up.
I've been studying for like 13 hours now, and I really don't feel like I've made much progress.
Shh.
All these reactions and chemicals, they all start to look the same. And I've got another 12 hours before the test. And so what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna study for about 5 more hours, and then go get some food.
Oh.